Hi, this is Jacob L.E., jacoblevideoproduction.com, and in this tutorial, I'm really going to go into the best way to export and upload and optimize your video for uploading it to Facebook. We're really going to get into the nitty-gritty on image formats and different tags and ways to set it up so you get the most reach and the most possible views, but I'm going to keep it simple and fun and to the point. So let's get started right away. So I've edited this video. You could potentially just take something from your phone as well. And I made this video a square. How I did that is I just made a new video or project with custom. So no matter what you're using, I made a 1080 by 1080. So it's a square. The reason square posts do better, they just take up so much more space in the timeline. They're way more prominent. And if you're on mobile, it takes up so much more of your screen. So on my timeline, here's square, what that looks like. And you can see for this video, you know, it still absolutely works, but it just takes up a lot less space. It's a little bit more than half as much as, you know, these big prominent things. So we are going to make it a square, and I just had to adjust my footage size a little bit. You can see I rotated a little and then just sized it properly. So I'm just going to export this, no matter what you're using or no matter what it is. We just want to make sure that it's in an H.264 or MP4 format. And that's just a decent high quality format that's compressed, so it'll upload well. It's not gonna be 4 gigs or 3 gigs or something like that. And I'm just going to choose exactly where I wanna save this to. And for Facebook. All right, so I'm gonna export that real quick. And while that's exporting, I'm just gonna hop into my Facebook business page. And I'm gonna do a new post. So I'll go to write post and under photo video, I'm going to choose upload photos or a video. I'm gonna wait a moment while this exports. That'll generally take a couple minutes. You do want your Facebook videos to be uploaded to Facebook. So not sharing your YouTube video to Facebook or from another platform to Facebook. Facebook is not going to actually show that to many people. It's been shown that Facebook shows videos that were uploaded on their platforms 10 times as much as, you know, a YouTube video linked out. So you're gonna get so much more reach. That's really the route that you want to go. Unless your only main priority is growing a YouTube channel and you just want one more share to give you a couple more views, you're gonna reach a lot more if you do it directly to Facebook. All right, so we have our video. I'm now going to select that and click open. And that will get the process started. You can see here's the upload percentage. Depending how long your video is, that will impact it. This is a little over a minute, which is actually a really good length. Videos around a minute tend to do the very best on Facebook. This is completely different from YouTube. YouTube videos that are 7, 9, 12, 15, 30 minutes actually do really well because they're really structured on keeping people watching on that platform, whereas Facebook, people are there to look at pictures of friends and family and probably aren't going to divert a long portion of their attention because your video is probably not the reason they went on to the platform in the first place. So we're going to give our video a title, and we really want to think about, you know, what would entice people. It could be shocking or surprising. Honestly, I'm answering a very specific question, so I just want to make my post appeal to people who want to know the answer to that question. So it is organic reach on, actually I'm gonna start, just looks better I think sometimes with the first letter capitalized. is organic reach better on a personal Instagram account versus a business account? So this is the question I get asked a lot. It's something people want to know. I found a big study on that and I'm just talking about it briefly. So I'm going to write up a description and you can decide. Sometimes it's nice to give people kind of an overview of what you're about to talk about. And then other times you don't want to give people the exact answer. This is a shorter one, so I'm going to try to entice people a little bit, but not give the specific answer in the description. All right, so here is what I came up with. Is it worth switching over your Instagram to a business account? Are you still going to reach the same number of people? Luckily, a big study looked at thousands of results and found the answer to the question, do personal accounts get more traction than business accounts? And then I'm just saying, oh, leave a comment. Have you found success? It's trying to start a conversation with people and asking them to tag someone if it's completely relevant. Now you do wanna be a little cautious just with how you set up the request to comment. They said, Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg said that they are cracking down a little bit on comment baiting, which is just trying to get as many comments as possible with, let's say it's a picture of Justin Bieber and Selena Gomez, and it's like, who is better? Like for Justin Bieber, comment for Selena Gomez. And they see that as kind of trying to game the system and trick it. So it's usually better if you just do a little comment, just directly relevant with the video, asking people and trying to start a conversation and see if you can help some people with this. Now you can use a few tags, just what people would be searching for. So I'm going to do Instagram personal versus business account. I'll do a shortened one of just Instagram business account versus personal. So thumbnails on Facebook are not nearly as important as on YouTube, where you'd want kind of text and different things like that. And it's the reason people decide whether to click or not. Thumbnails on Facebook, people are just scrolling through their feed and they'll just see this thumbnail for like a quarter of a second. So you don't want to do text. You don't want to do anything crazy. But this is just the initial flash they'll see. So if there's something amazing in the video, you could do your thumbnail as that. Or I'm just going to choose a part where I'm not making a weird face. So you can do your own video frame, like an exact frame. This will just give you like 10 options or a custom image. So if you were doing like a travel vlog with this amazing picture of a beach or something like that, that could be a good thumbnail image. But for this, just my face works fine. This one is incredibly important. 85% of people are on Facebook with their sound off. So you have to have captions on there. And you can do a couple different things. You want to choose your language. Probably English if you're watching this video. The easiest for most people is going to be to auto-generate them. And what this will do, it'll go through the video and try to hear the words that are going to be said and then time it out with your video. So it's not perfect. You'll have to look over it to make sure it's accurate, but this is a really nice feature. It will take a minute to actually generate the captions. A lot longer if it's a much longer video. And the only time you'd want to upload is like for YouTube. We had this video in YouTube already and we'd already done all the captions and figuring this all out and just wanted to import this over. What we could do is we could click actions and download a .srt file, and this would just be all of the captions from our video. And what we could do is we could click upload and then select that exact file and then just upload it exactly like that. If you want my full guide on uploading to YouTube, I'm going to have a card come up for it right there. We can set the default language just for the future. So it has auto-generated and done the text with different areas of the video. So what we can do is just look through, and sometimes there's going to be some obvious changes. So for example, here, are still using personal Instagram accounts when I first meet with them. That would be a period.
Now, Instagram does not.
Now, comma. So it read that slightly different. That's not a significant error, but one little quick change that I can make. Business account. So yeah, just scroll through. And it can be a good idea to just watch it one more time, make sure that the video looks good, make sure the captions line up. All right, so it did a pretty good job. I only had to make a couple quick tweaks. I am going to save this draft. And, you know, another way, I mentioned the clickbaiting. You can create polls within the video where you ask people a question that pops up on the screen. So that's another way you can potentially generate more engagement. So we can see the exact time code. So we're gonna ask the question, do you have a personal or business Instagram account? And just do personal business and neither. And now this poll can be a part of our video for the first 30 seconds of the video. It'll be just in the corner. And if you want, you can have specific labels. If you have a lot of videos, a way for you to find the videos later or to categorize them. You don't really have to do this. This is just something for you. The last thing I'll mention, you can also create a playlist, so just a way to organize some of your videos. So I could create a playlist called Instagram Marketing. So I'll make that playlist because I think I'll have some future videos that will be on the subject of marketing with Instagram. So I'm gonna click next. And you can do premiere or schedule it if I wanted to go out at a specific time or 8 a.m. tomorrow. Sometimes I've found that on different platforms, my audience is the most awake at 8 a.m., but I like sleeping in, running my own business. So I will schedule stuff to go out while I'm sleeping. But right now, I'm going to just publish this right now. Premieres can be effective. That'll, you know, let people know when the video is being released. If it's a big announcement or something engaging, that can be a good option to drum up some interest. And we do want to leave on reactions, comments, commentary, shares. All of that will really help. It's going to be so hard without having those likes and shares for many people at all to be able to see this. So I'm going to click publish. And we'll have to wait for it a little bit. We do want news feed, display and watch, allow embedding. That way more people can see it. And it'll take a minute to process. But now it's preparing. Cool, so we are live now. Everyone can see it. We have the option to boost it. So boosting it, will this mean more people seeing it? It's basically advertising it. We could create a separate ad and run Facebook ads. Just know it's pretty easy to just blast through money really quickly. So it does increase your reach, but you know, a very small percentage of people on your page will actually be able to see your content. So I think it's gonna be best use of your money is to just put a little toward making sure every single follower will see your video. Because if you're spending money to just do completely cold outreach to people who have never heard of you or are unfamiliar, that's just not as effective of a use of money. You do want to get really specific about who you're targeting and, you know, have the potential to reach some more of those people But I think a good starting place is making sure everyone who is already engaging with your business and likes your content actually gets to see it. So this is a decent option, people who like your page and their friends. And you can choose a very specific targeting. So this is very powerful. The thing is, this is generally the most effective when you're running a whole bunch of tests and different ads and different audiences. You're less likely to be super successful with it, just choosing one little audience, one video, and just pumping a ton of cash into it. But if you spend a lot of time, it is good to have it reach more people. I just kind of prefer Instagram, where you naturally reach way more people, significantly higher percentage than from a business page. This video actually is about business personal account versus business account, and the reach is around the same right now, which is not even close to true on Facebook. Anyway, so that is boosting posts. Let me know if you want me to do a full video on those. I have had some successful boosted posts, but it does get kind of exhausting just having to pump money every single post to reach new people, especially when there's platforms that you can do that without spending a lot of additional money. Anyway, I hope that this video has been helpful for you. I hope it answered every single question, but I want to know from you. Have you found Facebook videos to be effective? Is this part of your plan? Are you interested in Facebook videos, or are you completely done with it? Actually, surprisingly, live videos do a lot better than pre-prepared ones on Facebook, so that's one thing to think about. However, it is a powerful tool, especially if you want to be running ads and advertising. It's a little less effective if you don't want to be putting money behind it. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this tutorial. Please subscribe and click the bell to be notified when I come out with new content. Thanks, I'll see you in the next video.